Hello. See, here we have a data sheet for Zener diode with us. We have studied Zener shunt regulator, and then we know that in Zener shunt regulator, Zener is the only active element. You just connect one series resistor, one load resistor, connect Zener at the center, and you will get regulated output voltage. Right? So Zener is the major and active element. Now, as if we have seen Zener shunt regulator, its operation, then before starting with the design of Zener shunt regulator, we must understand its specifications, is it? And where specifications are collected, those are collected here in the data sheet. So I am having a data sheet for Zener diode. So the study of data sheet is basically used, or it is useful to choose or to select the particular component. For example, see, in the first column I have so many Zener diode. Those are Zener diode models. This is 1N4370, 4371, 4372. Those are different Zener diodes. So out of those so many different Zener diodes, which one is suitable for our design? That's what we have to study, and then we will select that Zener diode particularly. Right. So that is why before starting with the designing of Zener diode, it is very important to know about its data sheet. So let us start with the study of data sheet for a particular Zener diode only. We have seen the data sheet related to the rectifier diode also before starting with the designing of rectifiers and filters. Right? And that's why now, before starting with the Zener diode regulators, let's check out the data sheet for Zener diode. Look at this one. How many columns are there? First, then second, third column is test current, fourth column is impedance, and fifth column is its current. So total five columns are there. In the first column, as I said, in the first column, what we have different modules of Zener diode. 4370. This is 1N4300, 4371, 72. Like this, we have so many different Zener diodes are listed in the first column. Said, and in the second column, what is that? It is Zener voltage. See, they have written it is a Zener voltage. It clearly means it is a Zener breakdown voltage. Is it VZ? You remember we have used this same word VZ. Is it VZ? But here in the data sheet, see what they have written: Zener voltage in bracket VZ, the notation which is same as we have used. But look at this. This is very much important. What they have written at IZT. It means at IZT, that is at Zener test current. So what is that ZT? ZT is stand for Zener test. ZT. So I stands for current. So Zener's breakdown voltage at its test current is 2.4 volt for this first Zener diode. It means, look at the second example. For the Zener diode with model 4371, it has breakdown voltage of 2.7 volt at its Zener test current. And now what is that Zener test current is specified in the third column. We will go there immediately. So first understand the second column. So second column indicates its breakdown voltage. For example, for this 4372, its breakdown voltage is 3. For 746, breakdown voltage is 3.3. For this module, breakdown voltage is this. So whenever you want to purchase a Zener diode, what you need to do, go to the electronics shop and ask for its breakdown voltage. Is it? Yes, do you understand? Go to the electron shop and ask for ki mujhe 7 volt ka Zener de do. That's what you will say only. Mujhe 7 volt ka Zener de do. The shopkeeper will understand by its own that I am talking about, or you are talking about, a breakdown voltage of a Zener. You just need to specify the voltage. The major and important parameter of Zener diode is its breakdown voltage. Is it? So you just say a volt. Next person will automatically understand that we people are talking about its breakdown voltage. It is a universal mutual understanding, is it not? So that's why the second column specifies its breakdown voltage, which is VZ, the same notation that we have used. Now at IZT, that we'll focus on that word at IZT in the next column. Look at this third column. In third column, what they have referred? A Zener test current. It means they have tested a particular Zener at that current. हमने इस Zener को इतने करंट पे टेस्ट किया है, दैट इज द मीनिंग एक्चुअली. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी हैव टेस्टेड, इट मीन्स दे हैव एक्चुअली, दे हैव टेस्टेड दिस Zener 4372 एट अ करंट ऑफ 20 मिली एम्पियर एंड दे फाउंड इट्स ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज एट 3 वोल्ट. मतलब क्या किया उन्होंने, 4372 ये जो Zener डायोड है उसको उन्होंने एक फिक्स्ड करंट पे टेस्ट किया, एक करंट उसका फिक्स रखा और उस करंट पे टेस्ट किया. एंड व्हाट दे हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट इट्स ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज इज कॉन्स्टेंटली 3 वोल्ट, इज इट, फॉर दिस 20 मिली एम्पियर्स, इज इट, फॉर दिस 20 मिली एम्पियर्स दैट Zener शोज कॉन्स्टेंट ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज ऑफ 3 वोल्ट. सो दैट्स वाई दे आर राइटिंग Zener ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज इज 3 वोल्ट एट 20 मिली एम्पियर्स, दैट इज एट IZT. Now what the meaning of second column with reference to the third column, is it Zener breakdown voltage at that particular Zener current, and that particular Zener current is generally referred to IZT. Now one important thing that I want to tell you here is IZT is a test current, it is not a IZ minimum. Ye Zener minimum current nahi hai, it is not a minimum Zener current in the reverse bias. No, it's not like that. Two things are completely different. I'm saying two things are completely different, but if you check value wise, then they are quite similar. It means, why I'm saying quite similar again, is it? See, I'm saying something and again I'm folding my own statement. I'm just taking U-turn. It's not like that. IZT is a different thing. It is a test current of Zener. But while designing Zener shunt regulator, if you consider that IZT equals to IZ minimum, then also it is okay. Why? Because that is the minimum Zener current when Zener is in breakdown, and IZT is a minimum current, that is also a minimum current. Technically it is not minimum, but it seems to be minimum. It is a minimum current when Zener is in breakdown. Look at both definitions. So how we have defined Zener breakdown voltage? Zener breakdown voltage is defined at IZT. Is it? So if you change IZT, the breakdown voltage will change in very small amount. Is it? So that's why while designing Zener shunt regulator, generally if there is no way to calculate IZ minimum, people take IZT as its minimum Zener current. And for some people take IZ minimum also 10% of IZT. Some people do that also, is it? But see, those are very approximate value and it has a very negligible effect on the regulator's design, is it? It has very less effect. So that's why even if you consider IZT is equal to IZ minimum, then also it is okay at the time of designing. But remember, two things are different. It is the minimum Zener current, and IZ minimum is the minimum Zener current, and IZT is a current at which its breakdown voltage is tested. That is the basic difference, is it? Now come to the fourth column. The fourth column is Zener impedance. You remember I have drawn equivalent circuit, and then while drawing equivalent circuit, let me draw it here. This is RS, and then we had this one resistor. I said it is small R and Z. What is that RZ? This RZ is Zener impedance. When Zener is in breakdown region, it offers some impedance. So this impedance is specified in this fourth column. For example, the first 1N4370, this Zener diode, when it is in breakdown, it offers 30 ohm impedance. With it, take another example. This is 1N756. this zener diode gives breakdown voltage of 8.2 volt at the zener current of 20 milliampere and it offers 8 ohm impedance. Is it? So what this ZT is zener impedance when it is in breakdown region. That is what your fourth column. Come to the fifth one. Here they have clearly written maximum zener current. That is, when zener is in reverse bias, then its ability to handle maximum reverse current is specified in this column. So for the first zener diode, that is 1N4370, that 4370 diode can handle maximum 150 milliampere current through it. If the current goes beyond 150 milliampere, definitely the diode will get damaged. The zener diode will get damaged after 150 milliampere. So this is the ability, this is the capacity of a zener diode to handle maximum current. That up to that current it can handle, no issue, but if current goes beyond that, definitely diode will get damaged. You will get improper performance from a zener diode. Is it? This is the fifth column. Look at this, this zener diode 1N756, this zener diode gives 8.2 volt breakdown voltage at 20 milliampere and it offers 8 ohm impedance. And the maximum current handling capacity of that zener diode is 45 milliampere. So beyond 45, if current increases, the zener diode will get damaged. Is it? So those are five columns, five specifications, or you can say five ratings of a zener diode. So this is a cumulative data sheet I have, and that's why I'm explaining this. If you want a particular zener diodes all specifications in detail, then go to the Google, type the model number. For example, if it is 1N759, then I will type on Google 1N759 data sheet. You will get data sheet of 759 from different manufacturers. Is that the way to find data sheet? So this is all about the data sheet for zener diode. This data will be useful while designing zener shunt regulator or transistor shunt regulator or wherever we are using the zener diode. Is that? So it's all about data sheet. Now it is possible for us, or it will be easier for us to start with design of zener shunt regulators. Okay, thanks a lot.